Hi my dear student, today we will discuss chapter 2 complex number, exercise 2.4, third problem. In this case, two different complex number is given, Z1 and Z2. You want to find out the inverse of Z1 into Z2 and Z1 by Z2. But they are asking, find the inverse. They didn't say inverse with respect to addition or multiplication. So, you should find out both. Inverse, additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. And one more point, if you are going to multiply a complex number and its conjugate, it's very simple, which is nothing but sum of the squares of real part and imaginary part. Suppose you are going to multiply two different complex number, let me explain in a simple way. For example, I have x plus iy is a complex number, a plus ib is another complex number. These two are two different complex numbers. The very simple way is real part into real part minus imaginary part into imaginary part plus I times real into imaginary, imaginary into real. I'll explain first real into real, real into real minus imaginary part into imaginary part, by. Why I am writing minus here? Because I into I square, it gives minus 1. That's why this minus comes. This is purely real part plus I times real into imaginary. Real from here, imaginary from here. X into B. Imaginary into real. Imaginary from here, real from here. A, Y. So when you do like this, you will get the product of two different complex numbers. And of course, you will get the real part directly and imaginary part directly. Find the inverse of Z1, Z2 and Z1 by Z2. First, find out the product Z1, Z2. 2 minus I into minus 4 plus 3i. I will use the same. Real into real. 2 into minus 4, minus 8. Minus. Minus. Imaginary part into imaginary part. What is imaginary part? Minus 1, here plus 3. Minus 1 into 3, minus 3. So already you have minus, so it will be plus 3. Plus I times real into imaginary. 2 into 3, 6. Imaginary into real. Minus 1 into minus 4, plus 4. It will be minus 5 plus 10, 9. And find out Z1 divided by Z2. Z1, 2 minus I. Z2. Minus 4 plus 3i. If I present in the denominator, you want to multiply and divide the conjugate. The conjugate of minus 4 plus 3i is minus 4 minus 3i. Same rule, I'll follow. Real into real. Minus 8. 2 into minus 4, minus 8. Minus imaginary part into imaginary part. Minus 1 into minus 3, plus 3. Plus 3. That's all. Plus I times real into imaginary. 2 into minus 3, minus 6. Imaginary into real. Minus 1 into minus 4, plus 4. Denominator, product of complex number and its conjugate, which is always sum of the square of real part and imaginary part. It will be minus 11. And this will be minus 2 with I. 16 plus 9, 25. Got it? Now, additive inverse of Z1, Z2. Additive inverse of Z1, Z2 is minus Z1, Z2. That is minus of minus 5 plus 10, 9. It will be 5 minus 10, 9. That's all. Additive inverse of Z1 into Z2 is minus Z1, Z2. That is minus of minus 5 plus 10, 9. It will be minus into minus plus 5, minus into plus minus 10, 9. Now, additive inverse of Z1 by Z2 is minus Z1 by Z2. What is Z1 by Z2? That is what it. So, minus minus 11 minus 2i by 25. Now, what we are getting? Minus into minus plus 11, minus into minus plus 2i divided by 25. So, this is additive inverse of Z1, Z2 and this is additive inverse of Z1 by Z2. Just we are changing the sign. Suppose, in case of multiplicative inverse, multiplicative inverse of Z1, Z2. What is multiplicative inverse of Z1, Z2? That is 1 by Z1, Z2. Multiplicative inverse of a complex number is nothing but reciprocal. 1 by Z1, Z2. 1 by, what is Z1, Z2? Minus 5 plus 10i. I have I present in the denominator, just multiply and divide the conjugate. Minus 5 minus 10i. Multiply by 1, it gives minus 5 minus 10i. Divided by product of complex number and its conjugate, which is sum of the square of real part and imaginary part. It will be minus 5 minus 10i. Denominator 25 and this is 100. 100 plus 25, 125. This is the multiplicative inverse of Z1, Z2. That is 1 by Z1, Z2. When you simplify, you are getting minus 5 minus 10i divided by 125. I can cancel by 5. This one, when you divide by 5, numerator denominator minus 1. And this is 2 times and it will be 25. When you divide, you are taking common 5. It will be minus 1, it will be minus 2i, 5 cancel here 25 times. So this is the multiplicative inverse of Z1, Z2. Now, multiplicative inverse of Z1 by Z2 is 1 by Z1 by Z2. That is reciprocal of Z1 by Z2. What is Z1 by Z2? Minus 11 minus 2i by 25. So the reciprocal will be 25 by minus 11 minus 2i. 25 divided by minus 11 minus 2y. If I present in the denominator, you want to multiply and divide the conjugate. The conjugate of minus 11 minus 2y is minus 11 plus 2y. Multiply and divide. Multiply 25 times minus 11 plus 2y. Denominator real part square 11 square plus imaginary part square 2 square. So it will be 25 minus 11 plus 2y. It will be 121. Plus 4, 125. So it will be 125. So this 125 cancel here, minus 11 plus 2y. How many times? 5 times. This is the multiplicative inverse of Z1 by Z2. I'll tell you, multiplicative inverse of Z1 by Z2 is 1 by Z1 by Z2. That is reciprocal. So when you reciprocal Z1 by Z2, it gives 25 by minus 11 minus 2y. 5 present in the denominator from bring into standard form, just multiply and divide the conjugate. When you do denominator 125, this 25 cancel here 5 times. So multiplicative inverse of Z1 by Z2 is minus 11 plus 2y divided by 5. Got it?